My name is Ken Finn, and I work at the Exploratorium. And I'm here right now in San Francisco on Church Street near 21st, and I'm at the edge of the continent. In fact, I'm at the edge of the North American plate, where it butts up against the Pacific Ocean, a place of a lot of seismic activity. One of the things I like about right here is right under this apartment building, there's an amazing rock formation. It's a kind of rock called Franciscan melange, which means a mixture. And you can see it's a sedimentary rock. It's layers of very, very old mud that's been compressed over time, but falls apart quite easily. But what I'd really like to show you here is an amazing record of the motion of the Earth's crust. Look at these waves. Look at these frozen worlds. This is a place of a lot of seismic activity. In this box, I've layered some different materials, and as I press on it, I'm going to simulate the subduction that happened here long, long ago. The white band shows you how some of these waves in the Earth's crust can occur. Here I am on NOAA between 19th and 20th to show you another rock formation. This rock is an igneous rock called basalt. It's the most plentiful rock on the surface of the Earth. Most plentiful because it covers the ocean floor. Ocean floor, then what's it doing here on NOAA? We're in a very seismically active area where our plate is riding up over the ocean's plate, and sometimes some of that ocean rock is lifted up onto the land where we are now. This kind of basalt is called pillow basalt. It has a blobby, pillowy form because it was formed underwater at underwater volcano sites. Magma extrudes out of the earth and cools quickly, forming this dense, dark-colored rock that's now here on NOAA Street. I'm here at the State Street Park, just below the Randall Museum, to show you this outcropping of a sedimentary rock called chert. Now, chert's quite plentiful here in San Francisco, and it's made out of the fossilized remains of plankton that had collected after it died into a sludge on the bottom of the ocean floor. Then, after many years of pressure and temperature, it turns to rock. I like chert because you can see very clearly the bands of the sediment that forms this rock. And it breaks into wonderful kind of cubic shapes. You can see that behind me, where the rocks have very squarish looks, and as they break apart and tumble down this cliff, they're in kind of cubic looking things with many, many right angles. Now, an interesting thing about the sediment that makes up this chert, it collects and pressurizes and collects and pressurizes at a rate of about a millimeter in 1,000 years. To get the thickness of this dime would take 1,300 years. This awesome formation is found in a little park near the intersection of 15th Street and Beaver. It's called a slick and slide, and it's evidence of a gigantic fault. This is chert, like we looked at before, but its journey on that fault line has hardened it. It's a hardened form of chert, so now it's almost like a metamorphic rock, a rock that is morphed or changed into a much tougher version. That journey was so violent, you can still see the skid marks left in this rock as it was thrust up through the Earth's surface. It is so smooth and polished that it looks wet, but this is a dry rock.